I'm Peter Brown from Tiny & Sons Glass. Tiny & Sons Glass was established in 1978 with my father and brother and I. We're at 575 Washington Street in Pembroke. We're certified and qualified to do all your windshield replacement and repair. Tiny & Sons Glass is a community-based business. We have 12 mobile vans that come to you. If the weather's bad, you can come here to the shop. We have a nice waiting area, TV, Wi-Fi, kid-friendly, pet-friendly. We also can move about 15, 20 cars a day through the shop. Perfect for you when the weather's bad. So come on down to Tiny & Sons Glass if you need your windshield replaced or repaired. Tiny & Sons Glass, 1-888-64-TINIES. Just call. Thank you.
I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
Now 7:30, I'd like to open this meeting of the Pembroke Conservation Commission. The members present are myself, Andy Stevenson, Art Edgerton, Rick Madden, Scott Globin, butchered your name.
It's been butchered before, no big deal.
Oh man, long day. Bob Clark and Rachel Michael, our administrative assistant. Let's see. Our first hearing is 7:40 at 7:32. We can go right on to the administrative business first. The first thing we have here is personnel is vote to accept the recommendation of conservation agent to hire Rachel Michael as part-time administrative agent to the commission.
So move. I just have a question about that. I'm wondering why the commission didn't have any say on what on who was going to be hired. I think Rachel's a great idea, but I was just wondering why we didn't have other choices.
Well, there would be the town administrator and myself went over all of the applications. There were two applications, actually there were three applications that would have met minimum requirements. The three of them were asked to come in to be interviewed. One of them declined. Two of them came in, and it was Mr. Thorne's and my recommendation that Rachel was already, was by far the best. Also, she'd been in training for 3 weeks, which is very, bring someone else in brand new without any training would require a long time to get them to even do it. And that was the reason why we do that. In fact, I believe that the meeting I asked if anyone had an objection about 3 weeks ago for me doing that, and at the time no one said anything.
Right. Yeah, that was covered then and went over it at the last meeting also.
Yeah, I asked at the last meeting.
Yeah, the last meeting it was covered.
I was okay with it as long as Bob was being included.
Right.
And like I say, Mr. Thorne and I interviewed him during the day at the convenience and asked him to come in again at night. It was just, again, when we were, if it had been a close thing, then we brought it before the board. I mean, the second person was very good. We've kept her on the line, our town has kept her on the line in case something else comes up, but for this position, we couldn't touch Rachel.
Didn't I just see that she was the only candidate that applied? I just saw some from the minutes last week.
No, that's from February 6th. At that time, that was the only one that was there.
Okay, that's right.
Yeah, because it's in the agenda, it was written as the 27th, but it's the 6th. And at that point, that's what it was.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Yes, this meeting is also being recorded, too, sorry, for a broadcast on PAC TV or Pembroke thing. I forgot to say that. See what happens when they take my cheat sheet away from me?
I'm working on a new one.
I'm a mess.
So do we need a motion for that, or?
Bob made the motion.
Bob made the motion. I'll second it.
Okay, so a motion's been made and seconded. Is there any further discussion on that? Okay, so we're gonna vote to accept Rachel Michael as part-time administrative agent to the Conservation Commission. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. There is nobody to oppose, so it's unanimous. Welcome aboard. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Now you're gonna control it.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna have to put a plug. She's doing one hell of a job in there for staff.
Yes.
I agree wholeheartedly.
That's our going to school.
Except the email that you forwarded, like from Deb and somebody else that you put, and you said, "Hello, ladies."
Oh, sorry. Well, it was to them. Technically, it was okay because it was only to them, and you were just
sarcasm.
Observing.
Sarcasm.
I caught that, George.
I looked right away. I'm like,
ladies,
believe me, I thought an episode. I hope they won't be offended.
Well, I don't know. Saying
to offend me?
Okay, good.
Good luck with that.
Good. Okay.
Was that mail? I haven't read that yet. Rick has it.
Well, under the mail, we got National Grid is, and this is the first time I've ever seen this, that they have notified us of poles that they're going to be replacing that are in the buffer zone.
Okay.
Before they've always just done whatever they felt like doing. Now they listed 8 or 10 poles, and they're all ones that are, close to a piece of wetland, but they've never done it before. I don't know.
No.
Either they have someone new out there or something. But
they're catching up on the backlogs.
We don't have any say. It's not one of those things. We have no say about
it. Right, they're gonna do it anyway.
They're
gonna
do it anyway. So,
is there anything that's an issue? I don't know. Are there any issues with the ones they sent you?
Is there any? Anyway.
Are there any issues? Are there any that are a little too close or anything that...
No, I mean, the utilities pretty well are going to do what they have to do anyway. I mean, it's even, as I think we talked about last week, the gas company now doesn't even have to file. I mean, they just have to tell you what they're going to do.
Right. Plus, I think they take pretty good steps to protect resource areas.
They're watching out. And everybody's watching them too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
There was actually an issue on the blogs at Claremont Press.
Yeah.
I spotted something over there and I spoke to the gentleman that's sub to the contractor there, and they went right out and took care of it. They put some more hay wattles out because the hay wattles are getting disturbed. So they pretty much police themselves with it because they don't want the problems.
Right.
They have all mandates to follow and everything they do, so hammer friendly is good. That way, if there's something like it isn't marked like a main, road change.
Yeah,
none of those mains move all the time.
I think we already talked about the Water Street sidewalk.
Yep.
It's open for anyone who really wants to go.
That's this Wednesday, March 8th.
Yep.
I mean, you got a nice view of the North River.
As long as you get through the
pucker
brush first.
Yeah, you get through all the pucker brush and wade through half the water.
Yep.
And depending on the tide, I hear.
That tide, yeah.
Yep. Go down through Chucky Crosley's, you can.
Yep.
As long as you get your hip boots on, you're good.
I know that place. It's a nice old house.
And the chances are you'll see a lot of it later on as land start coming back in.
Yep. Okay.
It's good to get in there without the leaves on. Or you should go through the pucker brush without leaves.
Alright, so it's now 7:40, so I'd like to open the hearing. Let's say continuance for a notice of intent for 73 Taylor Street under Hashem DEP file number SE56-978 regarding construction of a new roadway and infrastructure for a 6-lot subdivision. And we're going to review the order of conditions on this, correct?
Tyler had called and said he had some things he wanted to bring in, so maybe we want to work a months, I don't know if you see, you...
I haven't seen any conditions either.
Have you?
No, I haven't passed it out yet, but I've got it here tonight.
Okay.
And you what?
My name is Deb Keller with Merrill Engineering.
Yeah. And you, sir?
Tyler Nims.
Tyler's the, the planning board and our...
Yep.
Engineer.
Just supposed to have them come up and introduce themselves. That was on my cheat sheet, I remember that.
Oops, I have a couple, oh no, this is, okay, yep.
So you've seen this, you've seen what we asked her to ask them, right, or our conditions?
I didn't, I only forwarded that to...
Okay, I can, I have a copy, you can...
Sorry.
No, no problem.
I think these two things are gonna kind of work together, is that...
I'm hoping so, yeah. Basically, my recommendations tonight is just stay in contact between this board and the planning board as far as what we want to do, make sure everybody's on the same page, that kind of thing.
And just to dovetail on that, just to give you a heads up, the planning board did have a site walk yesterday at the site at 10 o'clock. They reviewed some of the concerns of some of the abutters up closer to Taylor Street. I did not attend. Tom Pazerski from our office did.
Yes, and I did.
You did,
yes.
Okay. There were a couple of things that changed from the discussions yesterday. One was I provided a revised set of plans, Tyler. I haven't sent them to you yet, but they do include a 25-foot buffer along, and this is sort of outside of conservation, the 100-foot buffer, but it goes to just keeping everybody up to speed. This is Taylor Street here. And we've identified a 25-foot buffer easement to be maintained for the abutters located along that property line.
That 25 no-touch, what's there, is that...
It's vegetated, it's probably about 99% vegetated. I think there's one little spot where it's cleared here, which could be supplemented. They do want to keep some flexibility. They're trying to have some further conversations to see if they could relocate this. I don't know if that's going to happen. There was some talk of maybe putting the driveway here, so they want, which would go through that buffer, and then you'd clear it, and then you'd vegetate over here. But that none of that has been agreed upon, or so that. Trying to think of anything else that changed. Excuse me. It was just that. Well, we did add, it goes along with the operation and maintenance plan, a specific location for if they have to do any dewatering, that they would do that outside of the 100-foot buffer. I believe that's mentioned in the draft special conditions. So we did locate it up close to the existing home where it's already cleared, so it's stable, a stable location. So trying to keep the plans as consistent between planning and
engineering. Okay, would we move the hay bales if necessary and trim them out for siltation or
for the
dewatering?
Dewatering, we've proposed a dirt bag, or if they don't want to use it, the contractor doesn't want to use a dirt bag, they'd have to create a stilling basin to get out, and it would have to be surrounded with erosion control, etc. We are continued with the planning board until the 27th. I think that was because Ian Kelly and both Fisher are away and would miss the 13th. That sound I don't know if there was anything else that happened at the sidewalk that...
No, that seemed to be it. We, yeah, talked about that, staying close to the property line between the two pieces. We also talked that they could possibly look at coming off the road, get rid of the easements up there now, and come off the proposed subdivision road. And, but nothing was ironed.
Yeah, nothing was ironed out.
We didn't look at it to see if that was really feasible or not.
Now, I'd like to ask Tyler to review these.
Yes, yeah.
We'll give you, we actually, we can't really do anything till we, about the same time as the planning board, because if this plan changes, we have to, you know.
Yeah, we wanna stay on the same page.
So, what you, I don't know if anyone's really read it all, but I think they did a fine job on the orders. Tyler may find something that was left out, but I didn't see anything. I thought it was, it covered everything in good shape. I don't think we have any trouble with the plans as such, and all we really need to do is wait until we get a plan that, you know, that you think is final.
A definitive plan?
Yeah, definitive, so that...
Once it's all agreed on, then we...
So that we can vote on a plan number, which is what we have to put in the...
Right. I think that's what we were hoping with this set here. This could be as close to, if there's any changes that the planning board is gonna have, which they haven't indicated anything to us, it would be outside of the conservation's jurisdiction. But, again, if you want Tyler to review the special conditions...
I'd like to have Tyler at least review them, and all, and other than that, I don't think we have a problem with them. At least from my standpoint, I don't see a problem.
No, all the stipulations that we asked about at the last meeting, they're all in here, they're all worded.
Held down.
Yeah.
And we'll get...
Did our best.
We'll get the A whenever, we'll get the exhibit A when you have it.
Yes, yeah, I will ask it. I know they were both out of town, so I don't know if it's sitting in the inbox of their attorney or not.
But again, I don't think there's anything here that's gonna hold any of that. We're satisfied.
Okay, fantastic.
I am satisfied, I think the...
I am as well, yeah.
I wish we could be this swift and quick on, you know, efficient on, all the time.
Yeah.
Okay.
We appreciate you did agree for us.
Oh, good, I'm glad.
For us.
So we're gonna continue this again?
Yeah, I think we need to continue it till, well...
The same day as, or after the planning board.
When is it? Planning board gonna be the 27th?
Yeah.
That sounds familiar, yeah.
Is that what, I think you said 27th?
27th, yes. So you missed the 13th.
When we have it, yeah, this is the 13th. But, what, you'll read these and get us comment by next week. We don't need, we can, you know, you can get comments. We don't need you people here unless we have something that's changed. We'll let you know if it's big. And then we can have it ready, so the 27th, when you're there, we can have it, so we can sign it at that time.
Okay.
We'll have it all ready and, you know, vote and sign it that night and...
Either the 27th or the 3rd, it'd be the following Monday.
Yeah. I mean, that way it's done, it will be done at the same time, but then we sure don't wanna hold anything up.
No. No. No, I agree. Everything's in, everything was done as stipulated, so...
Yeah, I think we wanna put this off till next week for Tyler's comments on it. And we can take it from there. And then we'll go from there and get everything ready.
So...
So motion's been made to continue it?
Second.
Second it, until the 27th?
No, next week, because we wanna talk about Tyler's...
Next week.
We don't need any, we're just gonna do, unless he comes up with something big. If he does, we'll let you people, we'll know about it.
Okay.
Keep you in the loop, but it's no sense having to keep coming here while we're just waiting.
Okay, so if, let's just say next week, if everything's okay, would you just...
We'll
close it then?
We'll close it and then have it ready so that we can sign it the following week.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, we'll just continue it until Tyler looks at it, and if there's any changes we recommend, then it can go in, and then we can sign it in the final one, so...
Okay, that sounds great.
All right, so motion's made to continue it till the 13th. Yeah, 6 and 7.
7:40, is that, you got anything else on? You got that one more you advertised today.
That's the 20th. Yeah, we do, actually. We do. We have the RDA from, yeah, so we need it to move it. How do you typically take them? 10 minutes, 15 minutes?
This year, yeah, unless Tyler finds them, gets long-winded with this thing, we're going to be...
Okay, so 10 minutes?
10 minutes, yeah.
Okay, so 7:50.
Okay.
But we don't need them.
Yeah, unless you give me a shout. Okay.
Yeah, unless something comes
okay,
up.
Okay, so
if Tyler thinks we're going to need them, he can let you know, we'll let them know.
Okay. Okay. So, you made the motion, Bob?
Yep.
Do you have a second?
Scott seconded it.
Scott? Okay.
All in favor?
All right.
Yes.
Seconded.
Oh.
All three of us.
I want to make sure that that's all right. That's all.
That's true.
Maybe that's wrong.
That'd be
7:50.
50?
Yeah. Thank you, Tyler.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you, Deb. You've done a lot of our work.
I'm glad I could help.
Is it? Do I have something you wanted to say on the name of this?
Thank you, Bobby. Thank you.
Oh, okay.
I'll say who you are and say introduce. One of the neighbors of mine. Yep. You here to possibly become part of the board in the future? Or?
I believe his paperwork's going to make in the mail.
It
that
is?
Person's discontinued or whatnot. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I think
it's a lot of. Application and mail.
This is what these guys do.
All right.
It looks like
it's that. Come on. Steam.
Come on.
Old business. We have obtaining a new vehicle for the agent, which should be bought. That's under old business. Anything new on that, or?
Hearing what's
thank
the budget's
you.
Looking like this year,
yeah.
I can't see anything happening this year.
Okay.
Perhaps we can put it under that. There was a meeting in Town Hall of department heads Friday, and I was out of town. Rachel attended it. And basically that's what was said on the meeting is, we don't have enough money to keep going.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So we'll just put that off till next year.
But it is, like I say, I did speak with the chief. If something comes up over there, he'll let us know.
Perfect.
The second one is obtaining a new, it says lawn mowing machine, but I think we wanted something a little bit more than that, right?
Like a hard bushwhacker.
That was on the discussion, or?
That's going to go the same way as the car.
They're all things that we'd like to have in need, but right at the present time, heat in the building and lights are all we have to.
So we talked about that if we had somebody that could drive that, it could be used to mow the parks.
It could be.
It isn't an efficient machine to do what we need because it's only mowing directly behind and it's a rotary mower so it sticks way out. It's very clumsy. Is it better than nothing?
Driving reverse.
Just about, yeah.
Can we trade it in and get something that we can use better?
Sometimes I use it in reverse.
Well, if we could trade it in, but whatever we get was going to cost money. You know, as I don't believe in something that we could do anything of a lawnmower type would be completely useless.
Yeah.
We need
like a brush
the ideal thing is an arm mowed
boom foil
device that can work off of its side, but an arm mowing device that's capable of running a brush hog or a heavy duty blade because a lot of what you're cutting is going to be saplings or upwards of to an inch. So you need something that's,
oak and stuff
you know,
too.
It is not a grass cutter. You need a heavy duty cutter.
What if somebody was, I have a friend who has a gravely that something low on the front, it's antique, but the thing is built like an iron horse. An old walk behind Grayley would do for now, if we had one, just to open them somewhat in certain areas. I'm not saying it's the ideal thing. But,
yeah, I had Grayley, I've had Grayley's all along too, but it's
a little beyond that.
Yeah, a lot of the road is so rough on the sides that the Grayley with a sickle bar, depending whether you put a sickle bar or a rotary on the front, whichever, you're still only covering about 30 inches to 42 at them. At the most, and in order to get off the side of the road, there isn't enough room. Not even enough. So you're really doing one of these things, and maybe you are in that shape for that, Rick. But I mean, an hour and a half of that would be.
I was thinking of just more or less a brief opening, just so you have something instead of them closing right over in certain places that they're just blowing right over. There's not even a trail.
I don't know if I brought it up. I can't remember.
It'll like Brian's either.
There's always having the DPW crews come in on a Saturday and pay them their overtime rate to open them up. It's been done in the past.
There's that, and the other thing is getting prices from a few of the
subcontractors.
The subcontractors that are out there
that have that type of
machinery that can go through.
So do we ask Rachel to do that?
What?
Can Rachel do that?
Can we do it?
Can Rachel do it? Get the prices?
So we can I don't know if Rachel can do it, but Rachel's kind of hard to go out and tell. She's not, she can get people to come and look, but someone has to be able to take them and give them a quick cook's tour of what we want done so they can come up with a price. And I don't think Rachel in her heels is ready to
go pounding through
some of that. Well, those are the things we can ask, people to come in and look at it. I think we need to, as a board, look at it.
Decide what we want to do first.
Yeah, decide what we want, because if we wanted to do everything that we have control over, we have to have a person here full time to do it, because we have that much land and paths and all that's there. So we need to be a little conscious of how much money we're going to spend and what needs to be done first. So I would suggest that,
everyone
make a little list of where they think it is and kind of prioritize, and then get together and say, okay, three of us think this is more important than you two, so this is higher on our list. And
do you guys
and then get someone
priority what you'd support. Like to see
I
done?
I think the Bicentennial Trail, it's one of my favorites. It's got the Fred Flintstone.
Now the Bicentennial Trail... That's from what I was told last time is a chainsaw and log removing operation. Now
I haven't been down there myself.
Yeah, I have been down there, and I think it's something that if you don't act within a certain period of time, you're just going to have a forest without even a trail. And last time I was there in 10 minutes, just going down looking at the old steel, the rock fireplaces and stuff.
I have to be up front and honest with you. I don't have a clue what you're talking about.
Go straight past the police department over here. Go straight down to the dead end, by some handle trail. Is it called the sock off to the right? Goes in by the herring road?
Little Zap.
Yeah,
over here, Little Zap.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm honest.
But it's a really beautiful place. It's got some of the best high story, with no understory fern walks, just some of the best. You swear some of the moss rocks coming apart, 6-7 inches, 8-foot thick moss, looks like Arcadia National Forest. And I have pictures of it and walk through it, and it's beautiful to go in.
I know three years ago when it came up, people that looked at it and all were talking about it being a land clearing. Well, there was enough big trees down that it wasn't something you're just going to go in and cut up. It was going to require a piece of equipment to move. Even if you just cut either side of the path, what was left was big enough that it needed something else to move it. And it wasn't just one.
It's dead and dry now. I've looked at it, probably the last recent person to be in there, and I have films of all that on the camera. And I think it's, a weekend lark, to tell you the truth. With a chainsaw, it works. It's dead pine. It's light. Cut it up, throw it off the trail. Make salamander piles out of it, I see it as a thing that either way, it's a bicentennial trail. A lot of efforts got in, and it was all key-opped. All the plants, the trails were at one point. It was absolutely used a lot, and it's a beautiful oasis. And one of many, I know. But I just think it's a relatively small place compared to the big ones. We could start with it, get the systems, whatever we're going to use to get it done. It's a good place to start to learn what we're going to encounter and how much it's going to take. It's a good model to start with.
I think what stopped us last time is the chainsaw needs an operator, and it needs some bodies to move what the chainsaw cuts. And this is where things come to a grinding halt, is finding a chainsaw operators and strong backs to take care of the cuttings after it's done.
Yeah. Is that something we could ask the DPW to do over time also?
There's no manpower to do that right now.
Not on the weekends?
What does it come down to?
Yeah, you could see if you could get them to come in on weekends, but as far as the day-to-day stuff, there's no manpower available during a regular work week for that.
When you say a man with a chainsaw, is that a man with a chainsaw, somebody covered, or is that a volunteer with a chainsaw, or what is the spectrum?
It all depends what the board wants to do. I mean, right. If you can hire someone to come in and cut the logs and all that. That's it. But that's a different sort of person than the person that's going to be running a mowing machine on the side of the pass to take down there.
Right. So,
it's one of those things you've got to board has to decide their priorities of what they want done. I mean, it's nice to ask for volunteers, Rick, but volunteers are very hard to come by. And you still have to have someone who's going to be the head honcho for volunteers, so that you don't get four chainsaws and no strong backs.
Yeah, or four chainsaws in a row instead of one here and there. Line up guys with chainsaws.
You're still going to have the strong back people that can hold it out of the way.
You can actually deal with a lot of that by cutting really small, and they're like wheels. I mean, I think it can be done, some of it with volunteers, on this particular trail. I wouldn't say you could attack the whole town and get it done, but I think this particular area, you probably get enough volunteers to make a dent in it and open it up, We'd like to try at least.
And I have to ask, do we run into liability?
Yes.
Who's the insurance of the volunteers using chainsaws covering
you have to get the right team, make them special agents, as you would, put them under the coverage of the town and get some stuff done. I mean, it's not impossible.
That's why these union contracts, 10 days from every May, not going to happen.
Well, I'd like to think that we can form a solution that doesn't require a lot of money, and I always think volunteers, given the chance and an opportunity, which is hard to do today with all the liability issues and this and that, I understand that thoroughly. But when you start just subbing everything out and people don't have that custodialship of the land that they work on, like in your Boy Scout and Eagle Scout projects, they become identified with that in their life, and it's a thing that they become custodials. And to seem to lock that out because of this or that doesn't work right, I just think it's a shame to lose the ability to have that type of connection that the Cub Scouts and the Boy Scouts make and the Eagle Scouts make, exclusive to them, and you can't somehow work it out to become a project that works within the town. I'm just not going to say it 10 times.
First thing is, you're going to have a leader of the project who is going to be the person pushing the project.
New blood.
I nominate Rick for the head of this project.
If I can delegate somewhat and definitely get it done, I would definitely take it on for this one particular piece of property, because I deem it that valuable to the public interest to keep it open. I would accept if nominated and approved.
I think the biggest thing we have to look into, who's running the equipment.
Yeah.
Who's... As long as they're covered, that's all I really care about.
I just don't want it to go by the wayside.
Somebody get hurt and find out they're on their own.
Oh, no, absolutely not. That's not justified. Well, I've been in that shoe, okay?
So
I've been there.
So I think there's trails of Tubbs Meadow that need to be trimmed up a little bit, too.
Tubbs Meadow needs a mower.
Needs a big mower, absolutely.
That's, And now, Tubbs Meadow, I think I said this last week, Tubbs Meadow was done by a commercial outfit.
Yes.
I'm going to say 4 years ago, but I'll bet that it was more than that because of time went by. And my experience there was we should be doing these things from October through the 15th of March, because the last time we did it later on after the trees had already leaved.
Yeah.
And we were chastised.
Unpleasant things.
Yeah. We were chastised for it. It all grew back in a very short period. No, it looked good, but it didn't look good for about 3 or 4 weeks down there, and everybody that went down there had something to say about it.
And honestly, what could you maybe knock out? Some beehive nests around lake level that might be
Yeah, and
edge,
a few of the branches that hung down over the side and all that. It opened it up so you could walk 4 to 5 wide. No, it was nice, and it's lasted a lot of years.
So now's the time when we should do that, because it's on
the problem with the commercial
cuts.
They don't make a smooth cut.
The buds are already coming out on the maples and all now within another 2 or 3 days, the bees are out.
We shouldn't do it until eight, till October.
You might have fallen off the road on your bike to get today.
Minimize public concerns, it's best to do between fall and spring when the traffic is less out there.
You could do the mow, the downstairs, in other words, the mow part of it this time of year, and it would help. But if you start working 6 and 8 foot up in the canopy, which is the limbs that are really hanging down, that's where you see the damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, to me, it's, you know, everything works better with pruning in nature, as you know. You prune it, it comes back even stronger.
Yeah.
And I think the actual, I don't like the aesthetics of the splinter machine, but it doesn't come back quite as strict and quick as if you prune it, like with a saw.
Yeah.
It comes back 10 times faster. So I think they have their ups and their downs. But my point is, back to the Bicentennial Trail, is I've walked through there, and it's absolutely cross country. Yeah.
Well, and I think you're talking about this. To me, the Bicentennial Trail is a woods trail. Is a wood path.
Yeah, it's a mature forest.
Tubbs Meadow is a grown meadow. It has some trees, but not the type of trees you're finding down at Bicentennial. So you have to, each one of them would be handled. Yeah.
My point that I would say is seems to be trees versus mowing. I think if we got a team in there and cut the trees out of the way.
Yeah. And then Bicentennials could be done any time of the year, because the trees that are a problem are the trees that are already down and dead, so it isn't going to show that
you can actually see other people's work. In some of the places, they went in and started bucking it up and moving it off to the sides.
Yeah.
And I don't know who did that, but it's...
That was a volunteer group that was going to start it on it 3 years ago, and started for a little bit and ran out of gas.
Do them when they're green.
Is it, and like I say, I haven't been over there, can you drive into it?
No, not anymore. No,
you say it's no almost, and that was part of the problem when it came up last time, was getting a piece of equipment in there to be able to work, because it's, the entrance is down beside the house. But that's not its real entrance. Real entrance is other places, but the real entrance you can't get in on.
Well, they actually brought logging trucks in and out of there in the 50s. They brought everything out through that haul road, right up. You could drive a truck through there when I was a kid, no problem. And it's come in and come in and come in.
That was a long time.
But it was cleared right to the wall, right along the barn.
Exactly.
Yeah. And but that isn't our land.
Put a racket.
Well, we cleared it then. So.
Yeah. That's the walking entrance, but it's not the legal entrance.
So
do we need to have somebody come in and show us where we can get in and get out with a piece of equipment? I don't know.
I think getting rid of the trees is a matter of just walk in, and you guys can figure out how to get the other stuff in and out. That's just a walk in with some sauce. That's not even a long walk. I do that. I did the whole thing.
The biggest part to open up, as I've understood, and it's been a few years, was cutting up these trees that came down from the wind, and getting the path open. And you know, if you open the path and put them on either side, that's okay. It's not the best thing. The best thing is to to be taking that stuff right out of the area, but...
Well, it's tough right now. Chip price, if it was 2 years ago, chip prices were through the roof. The logs were worth something just to get them.
Yeah.
But now they're not getting paid anything for a load of chips.
I tend to disagree a little bit. When a tree falls in the forest and it gets buried under the litter and time goes by, they're called mother trees. And 90% of your reforestation takes place over top of a mother tree when you have a seed event that sprouts and windrows. That's how that occurs. So I think leaving the actual trees in the woods in slabs, you go back in a year, you lift them up, there's going to be all sorts of salamanders, lizards, amphibians, there's going to be everything living under them. So all the bugs will be in the bark. I mean, they're just going to decompose and create, you know, fodder for everything and become dirt again. I think slabbing them up and making salamander homes is good, just like behind the
an approximate ballpark, maybe from the DPW and something like that, on what it would be for a Saturday if on a crew, just a ballpark.
Yeah.
Nothing crazy.
Yeah.
For a crew of two or three or four guys, or if you have time to look maybe at tubs to see what needs
to be. To bring two guys in with the mowing machines,
yeah,
you're roughly looking at about $300 per guy. So you're looking at a $600 day, roughly.
Okay.
Because we don't charge for the machines.
Yeah.
They get a lot done, too.
They do.
They really do.
Right. There's no question. That's what I'm saying. It's something to factor in instead of saying, well, we could do this, we could do this. Well, yeah. What are we looking at, roughly?
Ballpark for an 8-hour day, you're looking at about $600.
Okay.
And I honestly think it's, you know, not because they're dead now, standing and up in the air, a lot easier to take them out, you know, cut dead pine is a lot easier and it's a lot lighter than a big old soaking tree.
Well, if we had to designate a certain allotment to say, obviously I haven't seen it, maybe we should put your eyes on what trails you can or what, I'm not going to speak for how much work you guys can do out of, you know, me, I'm a boss myself and you never get enough work done.
No.
But if you say, yeah, you know, we think maybe we could do this and this and this in four Saturdays, two a month or every other month so that they can be with their family, and we as a board can come together and say, okay, yeah, we'll designate $2,400 for improvement on the trails, provided we have the financing, or if it's in the budget, why don't we look at it first and put something together and then come up with an actual plan instead of going back and forth about, well, this one's more important.
Yeah.
I mean, Tubbs Meadow is... you know, probably a more common dog walking spot.
Yes.
There.
Yes.
I've never heard of the other one. I don't know if it's as big or if it's as open.
It's a much different environment.
But if we're just going to sit and go back and forth, why don't we actually put an eye on it and say, you know what, two guys can probably do this and this in two Saturdays and start on this and get the saws done and get it cleaned up. Then to go in from the outside, if it's whatever's best, why don't we have it looked at and give a rough ballpark first? You know, why don't we put that on the board and then go from there?
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's all from there, you know?
And just Bicentennial Trail is beautiful, except it has one major problem.
Deer ticks.
There's no parking.
Two spots.
Well, yeah.
And if they, and only if they like you.
Right. Well, yeah, you know, but that has been its problem, why it hasn't risen high on the list of things is because people can't, other than the people that are there, you can't get to it.
Sometimes that's better off for everything.
But we can do an access trail through the herring run to that ridge and out over the bottom ridge and back around. So it has potential in the future.
Right. There's,
you know,
it also has potential coming back the other way to the piece of property that the town bought for the Oldham Street drainage.
Yes,
going
right
down.
That's
on
right
the whole back there.
And that's
good for us to be thinking that way.
It is.
But we only can accomplish so much, and we aren't accomplishing anything, so don't bite off so much you get nothing done.
That's what I'm getting at. It's like, hey, you know, in 2 days we can open up tubs, be done, and have 100% access while we plan. We'll already know what it'll be roughly to have them go in. And once they look at the Bicentennial Trail, if they start saying, hey, we need two just to get at the front side, two more at that, and if we can do two in the front part of the season, two in the middle, and two in the end,
right,
that's fine. I mean, we're not hiring a full-time on Saturday, but without having the guys doing the job looking at it, make no mistake about it, I would certainly prefer to keep it with town guys if we can, if it's within a budget that we can set. I would rather have our guys do that.
I'd be glad to take on that job of going in there and actually, you have to have somebody else okay, like flag or whatever, the trees, somebody else would have to okay it, and cutting the bigger trees out of the way and rolling them out of the out of the way of the roads.
Right.
But I have to make sure, again, that it's copacetic, I'm not going to get in trouble, and I can handle a chainsaw all the time. I do it in water, I do it standing on my head, I do it in mud, I do it underwater, unfortunately. You got an underwater chainsaw?
Any of the steels.
You can start them afterwards. So, I mean, I wouldn't mind putting an effort into that to get it open and to try to even get that little trail opened in. I think if you don't open it, it just sits there and nobody knows it's there and the job gets harder and harder. But if you open the trail, I think in a place like that, it would be easy to bushwhack it every so often and keep it open rather than let it get overtaken again.
Well, I have to say my curiosity is...
I think I just heard Rick volunteered me the...
All in favor?
Yeah. never been over there.
Well, it was either Rick or Rachel. Does one of them need to leave the room?
Did I hear you say you were volunteering to take it to be the...
Woodcutter.
That's not what I'm saying. Being the overseer of the Bicentennial Trail improvements.
Give me a map, and I'll get at it, and yes, I'll do my best. I usually succeed on projects I start.
And if you can, whenever you get it, right, just give us
maps for the Bicentennial, very easy, because there's a number of
stone walls, everything there.
Yeah, there's a number of people that have done the mapping of that area, and it's in foldouts and all. And I know that right now Rachel is very deep in it, but in some of the draws, there's definitely Bicentennial literature that shows
up. I've never even heard of it.
The old man worked there, I did go and cut
five. If it's there, let's do a lot of work. Again, I don't know what the cost or something like that.
Parking has almost been the problem, because even the two parking places that Rick is talking about aren't necessary.
They have to like you.
Neighborhood friendly.
So it's like Misty Meadows.
Let's put it this way, they don't like deer hunters.
Yeah.
I get it, but if it's designated as parking for a town thing,
Well, I know, you know, it's one of those, is it designated?
Right, is it or isn't it?
Supposedly, when they put the cul-de-sac in and built the other houses, there was some parking at the cul-de-sac, but it's never really been...
I've never seen it.
Yeah, it's never really officially been done that way. Well, so
luckily,
you've got a house here, and the trail goes down beside the house and the barn, and with a stone wall. And if you walk here, it's fine, but it's not really wide enough to take a vehicle in.
Not anymore.
Nope. Right.
And like I said, entrance is farther on down, or up.
It's like Sandman's old house block.
In behind where Gillette's were and all.
Is that like, does it almost line up with Allen Street?
It's up in there, right up across from there.
Because Pat Salmon lived over there.
Yeah.
And I thought somebody said that was with the...
It goes in and makes a right-hand turn and goes around.
Right across from old house. Right across the street.
I'm not that old. Salmon was far as I was going back.
I think it's a worthy project, and I would like participate in it and lead it, and let's see what we can get done.
Done. Okay. Thank you, gentlemen, for that. Rick, for spearheading all the improvements in Bicentennial Trail, and Scott will put something together and give us a rough idea on his side for the ballpark.
Now that he said that, do we want to go ahead and have Scott look into getting his people to do a run around Tubbs Meadow before it gets...
Yes, well, that's what he said. He's going to go look at it and then give us a rough idea to say, you know what, we'll need two Saturdays, we can get in this far or however it works.
They had two people
when Mark Ford was
on one Saturday and did better than half of what was there. But this has grown up a little more, so the mowing's going to be a little tighter than it was before. But
with a rough idea and a ballpark estimate, we'll have a better plan than
Yeah, whatever.
If we know that they're going to have to do it, should we maybe vote to have them to start that now, because it's getting to be late and this stuff is starting to be grown up?
Well, the mowing that they would be doing, we can do anytime.
Yeah.
Because we're talking about
we'd be doing the
low mowing, not okay, high, right. Not high mowing.
Do we want a ballpark
bushwhacking more?
Yeah. Quote, for lack of a better term, first to make sure we have the funds. I mean, it's up to the board, really.
The worker.
Right.
So can we hire them for one day to go out there, and then we'll see what's there after that? We know we have to mow.
Well, I think we could easily tell. Let them go one day, and right. One Saturday, and then see what was left and decide then what to do. And we should easily be able to afford
right.
One day without.
Do we have to post that they'll be doing work on there, because it's a very popular area for dogs and people? I would like to see that put in the paper as so.
In the paper, it even notices right down there.
Yeah, yes.
I think we put it on the. Cable channel.
Yeah.
When we did it the last time.
I think what they're doing, they don't know what they're
doing. I understand that, and people will go to roll in and they want to know how it got authorized and who did it and who's this and who's that. As long as we're there ahead of time, I have, again, zero issue with that. Yeah. You know, if it was a matter of, hey, we can do the whole thing in two Saturdays, then we vote on authorizing two Saturdays, we'll do it. You know, if it's one, then they get a look at it and say, you know, we really need another one or two.
Well, see, the thing
I'm impartial on
the way we're set up, if they work a Saturday, we usually will be meeting the following Monday.
Yeah. Right.
And we'll know what they got done in one Saturday, and know if we need to authorize another Saturday. And I can pretty well tell you there's just no way that they're going to do it all in one day. Saturday.
No, there's no way.
And having worked it myself.
100% agree with that, and that's what I say. If we want to vote on one, sure, go right ahead. But so, let's give adequate time to post it.
For this time round, it might not even be worth putting the overhead machine in. We might be better off putting the we have 2 5-foot front mount mowers.
Yep. Yep.
They basically chew everything up. You might be better off this time around just sending them.
That's I agree.
Yep. Right. 100%. Right.
They'll probably make better timing.
Yep.
So I'll motion to hire the DPW on Saturday to do that initial round of mowing and touch metal.
Okay.
Second.
So a motion to Nate and second.
Do you want to put a number on it? Just so.
Well, two people for one day?
No, I know, but. So we have to make sure we have the resources.
No, we're going to spend no more than $1,000.
Right. Right, that'll I think will cover it with a little excess and whatever it runs into. So the motion,
because it may be one of those we plan an 8-hour day and they may get out there and find out, hey, for 2 more hours we can kind of complete the loop. I don't know, because it's been a long time stepping out there.
Yeah, it just has to be documented in town, people notified ahead of time.
I think, like you said, we ought to. I don't know how many entrances are there, but I know there's the one off of Mill Street, there's the one off of Monroe Street. Is there any other entrances into there? Or?
Well, entrances that you can really drive in from?
Any place somebody could where they could park and walk in.
Yeah, off of the new road.
Calliopath?
Calliopath.
Yeah. Okay.
You've got an entrance, a nice entrance right there.
Maybe we need to at least post those three areas, put something up on, there's a kiosk at Monroe Street, isn't there?
There is a kiosk off of the Center Street end, but it's pretty well, it hasn't been utilized for.
Yeah, it's got pine trees to speak.
Right. Well, we'd be looking roughly at least 2 weeks anyway.
Right, so maybe we need to get some signs made up, spend a couple bucks, get some signs made up that we could continually use going.
Yes.
Trail maintenance will be happening from this date, like we do the town meeting signs. We just get sticky letters and change the dates, but just get a general thing that trail maintenance will be done, and this is the week it's going to be done.
Yeah,
keep your small dogs on leash, please.
The best thing to do is try to keep people out of there, because those mowers will shoot crap 150 feet.
And safe auction.
Which is why I'm saying it needs to be made, notified, done, so posted for at least a week before they get in there and start cutting it.
Yep.
Plus, you're going to have to organize the crew anyways or whatever you want to do. That's fine.
That'll give me time to get in and take a ride around and see what's what.
Real quick.
I think also that if possible, board members and all may want to be visibly around there to make sure people that can't read understand that there's trail maintenance going on. In other words, there's always some people that you have a sign that they have to step over,
yes,
and still don't read it. I mean, and
right,
just to let them know that, yeah, you've got machines in here working, you know. You can't make you not go in, but you've got to be aware that
there's one of those empty or going risk.
To be safe, like, do it like, if you can't hear them, you got to, like, pretty much, if you can't hear a mower, you better be deaf. So maybe tell deaf people to watch out for flying.
Never mind near the mower, it's look at the green trucks with the trailers in the parking area.
Yeah.
Brought the mowers there. But it's all irrelevant, that's all hearsay, because we all know.
I didn't even say it.
We all have faith in everybody, and we'll leave it at that.
Yep.
So we'll,
as long as it's posted and we do our
right
part. Do what we've done our part, right.
Then that's it.
Yep.
Good.
And we'll deal with everything else as it happens.
So we'll post those three entrances.
Yes.
And like I say, even if we decide we're going someplace else, we can still pull. We can just pull those signs and use them wherever we're going to.
Perfect. So we'll vote a blanket 1,000
yep.
to cover it. If it's more, or if it's less, we just say, hey, we can do this, or if that's what it'll be for a couple, whatever it is,
yep.
that's fine. You let us know if you can get a crew together and say, yeah, I got two guys that'll do it this week, or two that'll do it this week. Fine. After it's posted, we'll get it all set and done. Okay.
Notification also, just we're going to use a chainsaw in there. We'll do some sort of like mail out or just mailbox thing a week before.
Running a chainsaw is not as
difficult
to maintain. As the machines.
We don't need 10 green police calls and, you know, calls to you guys.
Well, no, we will post it.
Yeah.
We have the town website that we can do.
There'll be work
on.
Being done on these trails and work in this trail.
I think one of the best things you can do, especially if it's a Saturday or when the town hall is open, just before you go there, stop next door and say, hey, just giving you guys a heads up.
Yep.
We'll be working in this area
because
they're the ones that are going to get the first call. There's a chainsaw running in my backyard and I don't know why.
Yeah. We call it a safety officer's job and we just alert them and let them know.
Yep.
Okay.
Great idea. And they don't pick up the dead limb, you know.
So all in favor to authorize a 1,000 blanket for DPW trail improvement and overtime for their workers?
At Tubbs Meadow?
Yeah, start at Tubbs Meadow and then we'll go from there.
Aye.
Actually, I should probably abstain.
Yeah, you should abstain, sir. Strike Scott's vote from the record, please.
Did you get time and a half?
That's not an official.
Did you get time and a half to watch on Saturday?
Again, nothing. It's called salary.
All right, thank you.
It's
all right.
All right, we're on to with chimney wood stove at Herring Park.
We started working today to get some of the permits and stuff together so we can get a cost on that.
Perfect.
And basically, we've got to find three. If we're going to do Mason, it's got to be three people we know. Anybody is eligible to say who they may want to do it. And if it's going to be a kit, then anybody stalls a kit, like the twin wall or whatever. I think Mason would be nice, myself. That's what I would kind of lean towards.
I'm
going to throw a little curve. If you're considering a chimney and the chimney touches the ground, then you're going to have to file paperwork before this board to put the chimney there.
Yeah,
because you're in an area that's within the buffer zone of a river. And I do not want to be asked why we can do it and somebody else
can't.
It'll be part of the quote whichever way we're going to end up going anyway. So.
Yeah. So that if it touches the ground, then I think if it doesn't touch the ground, then you know you're in a different category. Yeah. You're in where you aren't really disturbing what's there. You might be getting a little gray.
No. I agree with everything you just said.
Okay.
I agree 100% what you just said. Absolutely.
Can you build a chimney without it touching the ground?
Yes. You do a pipe. A twin insulated pipe comes off and.
Yeah.
You can actually box it and make it look like brick or anything you want.
Yeah.
There's other things, but I just want to make sure we're covering.
Absolutely.
Covering ourselves for the public.
The public.
Correct. All right, and wild parsnip and Natakeeset ball.
Real quick about wild parsnip, I went to that convention. We hooked up with a John Edgar. He's the principal of this company. Everything they do is organic and are within all guidelines of. It's water storm management and purification. Their list includes invasive removal. They are licensed to do on-road work or side-road work, every type of work in any area, which is good. Very personable person, and I want to get in touch with him and have him come in and just do a walkthrough. He's even talking about maybe using steam, high-pressure steam, to destroy roots and vegetation rather than chemicals. So,
yeah.
Pretty much state-of-the-art people. You want to look over their folder?
Yeah.
Now, it's.
I don't know if we talked about that. Did any of those people ever tried burning?
You have to do a high-intensity burn to kill the seeds. That's what the burning does. It only kills the seeds, and you could use an alcohol base,
I know a lot of some weed controls are done now with a pressure light type of tool, a torch, and you on bigger plants, and you actually burn the plant right down into the ground.
We did that on the driveways for years with the kerosene pump ones. Now they're selling. What I think is the logical thing to go to is steam, high pressure steam. It may be the way of the future, and they're doing steam wands already to devegetate places. And obviously, steam has nothing.
The other side of that coin, if you flip it this way, that I'm concerned about is like poison ivy. You burn poison ivy and get into smoke.
Yes.
And it's as bad, worse than having rolled in the poison ivy.
I don't know this one because it would have to be, again, UV activated, but your nostrils, around your eyes, who knows what could happen.
That's why I didn't know whether you had run into anyone who said yes or no on that part of it.
Lighting it on fire.
I think you'll never get the roots by burning on these things. I've burnt, chicory out. I've burnt everything out of driveways. And unless it's on the surface, you got to come back a bunch of times. But
well,
a lot of these things
you need to do
repeatedly,
numerous times.
Yes.
In the weed control business and the farming part of it,
this
most of them aren't one-time things. You get something now, you come back later on, you come back a third time before you really get the best of the plant.
I found this guy to be very honest. Art talked to him as well, and very experienced. And I think he is the go-to guy on this. And he's very organic, but if it comes down to it, and using the chemical, using it safely, using the correct chemicals, he'll do whatever needed to be done to get this managed. He understands the severity and how we can lose our wetlands totally to this plant. And that I gave him kudos. He's very informative and a go-getter. So I want to take and just put it across the board. I'd like to talk to this person further.
I think we've already, in the past, given you the
green
light to be Mr. Potter.
If he wants to walk us and see whatever
it takes, you back the answers.
Call ahead, napalm.
Have him come in and walk it or whatever he wants to do. I mean, if he wants to meet with us first, that's fine, but
a general walk it first.
Yeah, right.
Again, walk it first and give us a good, a rough idea of what this operation is going to cost us.
Right, because if we could do it with steam, that's ideal over any.
I don't really mind if we do it with chemicals, if that's the only way to get rid of this stuff, because if we don't take it serious and get rid of this stuff, we'll lose that whole metal.
Location-wise, chemicals would be the last absolute.
I agree 100% with you. But rather
than
lose our
weapons, I'm interested in hearing that.
I'm interested in hearing it all. I'm interested in getting rid of it. I've been hearing parsnip for 3 years, and it's my duties, and I feel like I'm not getting it done. So,
well, have them come in, Captain.
This is the year.
All right. And ball fields.
Does that have to do with the tree replacement or just the ball fields?
It's a tree. We're saying ball field only because that's
right.
Covers trees and.
I brought that pamphlet again from. This one here, it's the 16, but I don't know if we're, able to buy trees or not. I want to do a proposal that we see about buying a round number 300 trees, 500 trees, bare root, and plant them immediately upon receiving them without delay on bog 12.
See, now you're talking 3 and 5, and from my experience, 3 or 5 is a reasonable number to try to plant.
Right.
Yeah, if you're talking 3,000, then
yeah.
Well, you know, long before 3,000 are in your, and unless you can find a big crew, but yeah, 300 to 500 is a
you don't get a reasonable, break until there.
Yeah,
what? So that you don't get a break until about 300 or 500. That's why I said that. You don't want to pay expensive prices for trees.
Yeah, no, but 3 or 5 is a good. Wanted you to work with.
Why don't you jump out of that? We'll look through them.
Right. That's on bog 12, or is that something that recreation would still be doing because it was part of the original? Do we need to contact them?
Right, my point is.
Well, I think what we've kind of said is not, and nothing formal, but with recreation, if we would buy the trees,
right,
and then we will get the money from recreation.
Yes.
Right. And that way we can get the trees when we want the trees,
yeah,
and perfect. Not be waiting in between for all of the
and
rest.
And it avoids having like a kind of slush fund that we have at our disposal. We give a receipt, the trees, we get the money back. It's, yeah, it's easy to do that way.
Can we decide on a particular tree that comes out at the recreation department at the ball fields? Can we decide if they wanted a bigger tree?
Well, we had talked about bigger trees.
We were looking at the elm trees out in the green area.
Yes. So is this the time of year to get those too?
Those will not be available, I believe, until it's 2018. Those you had to
order in advance.
Be in advance.
Have we done that order?
No.
So we need to do
that. Can we get a price on those and lock it?
I have to go through the pile of crap in my office and look and see where other
I really do love the idea of some elm trees back. That would be
awesome. Make my best attempt to find that brochure. Yeah. But there's 6 or 8 boxes. Yep. I haven't even touched yet as far as our stuff, never mind my regular stuff.
I got you.
What have you been doing all winter?
That damn white stuff, Bob. Mm-hmm.
I got in trouble for doing that white stuff.
Yeah, I don't
know. All right, I'm not going down
there. Yeah, no, that's...
I'm going to leave that one
alone. Down.
All right.
So we have to add to.
Okay, so we'll look into the price on the trees and get right back to us on the next meeting.
Mm-hmm.
I also wanted to bring up, if it's new business, along with that real quick, get it off the dinner. I was thinking, where we're getting such a deal on those tables, Heron Park could use a few. And if we could get a few of the tables at that price,
I haven't even caught up with that gentleman yet.
I would think it would be nice to have a couple.
Well, what I'm going to
put them in right away, a reserve.
What I'm going to try to
that
do
good a price, then
is have this gentleman get the contact information so they can actually not bill him.
Right.
They'll bill us direct. And then maybe that'll set up a connection for us.
Well, my point was if we could extend the order to 2 more and get that done like we did last week, and so we get in under that 30-day umbrella and push that through as far as just getting that done with that, I would make a motion that we buy 2 more tables to be in that same order and to be stored until appropriately decided by the board where to put them at Herring Park and when.
So that would bring, we're probably up to almost 5,000 for that order.
Yeah.
So we just have to make sure we have funds available.
Right, because I like them. They're really good. And
they're beautiful.
You're not going to get a better price. So we don't have to put them out right away, but keep them in reserve for that park. It's a really...
I say I'm gonna hopefully catch up with them. I've been up there about every time, so I'm gonna try early tomorrow morning and see if.
In case anyone hasn't been up in that area,
yes,
the DPW has been clearing up and around the Williams Ford Rubber Mill, whatever we are calling this side of it.
I call it the rubber mill.
But having said that, it's that clearing is causing. I'm going to cause another problem because it's going to need some fencing of some sort very soon, because now that they've taken away all of the weed growth and all,
the natural
we
fence.
Have some drop-offs that are not at all safe.
No.
So we're creating another problem, but it's an improving problem. It's just we're going to have to, somewhere along the line, you know, do something with some more fencing. And not just any, not just some snow fence. I mean, yeah, we need to be thinking about long-term fence that looks good in that area.
And lasts, you know, lasts. How are they doing the knotweed there?
Again, if someplace, if you happen to be up in that area, drive by, stop and look at it, so you're getting a better idea of what we're going to have to be dealing with.
Talking the other day, cruising by, but I had to get right home.
Right now, we're, me and Bob and Mary met a month ago with Wildlands Trust.
Yep.
So we're working with Wildlands Trust, and they are very specific of what they want to do. So once we get it cleared out, and as soon as it starts to sprout again, we're to get a hold of, no, we're to get a hold of Wildlands Trust, because
if you don't treat it, that's when you do it. Yeah, that's when you treat it.
The town is going to do it. Wildlands Trust.
They can also have a problem with rain or anything. I've seen them spray tarp until it dissipates.
Yeah, I honestly don't know what his plan is. We're going to get it out of the way.
Yep.
And then just keep an eye on it. As soon as it sprouts, we're going to get a hold of Wildlands Trust.
Fast.
Well,
you know.
So we.
That's awesome. To get rid of that.
We're working on that, and Greg Ossie, I believe, is the guy's name. He lives in a big old farmhouse up the street, and he got together with, I believe it was just a petition he put in for CPC funds.
Yes.
And he was going for 6, I believe they bumped it up to 10, and that's for landscaping around that area.
Nice.
And the DPW is looking into putting a new sign up, just like Hanover has.
Yeah, we need.
So it's in the progress. Unfortunately, I had to inform Mr. Ossie that even though money is voting on in May this year, not April, money does not come available till July 1st. So we're doing part of it with working with Wildlands Trust. Yeah. So it's just an ongoing process, and we're going to try to keep it rolling.
Yeah, it really needs to work, and it's a great location to be spruced up.
Yeah, it is. I think we'll probably remember a few weeks or maybe a month and a half ago. We are also entering into a tri-town operation in that whole area between Hanson, Hanover, and Pembroke, and Wildlands Trust. And Wildlands Trust has made the approach to the state fund, wherever it is, and now we're just waiting to see how much we get and if we get.
I think we should.
That's for making the trail loop from one side up through the Hanson State Street around and back down. So you've got a walking trail all the way around.
That's like 4 miles, right? Right in there?
I think it's almost 5.
Yeah, it's four point something.
That goes by the cliff on the gorge too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like New Hampshire.
Goes by the big Dwelly sign.
Yep.
The rock that's out there's got Dwelly written on it.
Yep.
Or chiseled in it, I should say. It's not written in it.
So how big are those elm trees that you're talking about?
I believe the ones, and like I say, it's been so long since I looked at the brochure, I think they were 6-inch caliper.
That's
just. So this company has 4 to 6 foot trees?
Yeah, these would be, I would say these are more on the 10 to 12 foot size.
Probably bigger if they're an elm, because they go up.
I'm pretty sure that the ones we were looking at, it was a tree spade operation. It wasn't something you're going to dig up by hand.
No, that's what I'm saying. They're probably a little bigger than that even.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know, Hanover did a great thing a few years back. They actually went out into their woods and picked out some specimen trees. And they actually pruned them up, worked on them for about a year, got the area open, and then they actually hired Village Green with his big tree spade. And they came in and spaded them and kind of picked out the premier trees and put them in a few spots.
Nice.
And it worked out very well for them. So that may be an avenue we can look at somewhere down the road to try to move some mature trees
into some
better areas. We just have to, you know, take a walk through the woods and see what's out there.
That, right.
Those spades.
That actually would be a great idea for, like, sassafras. You can take 2 or 3 in a clump. And get established, because they seed in, you put them in and they seed in well. They start seeding in 2 or 3 years, 10-15 foot tree.
Because it was a good operation. I know Kurt McLean was in charge of it over in Hanover, and he's like me, he kind of, you know, we were born here and we're going to end up dying here. So
passing.
It was a good project they came to be.
It all goes back to you need someone that's going to be the pivot point of any of these projects that can put. We have a whole board of people, but you need one who's this is their project at the time, yeah. And they can coordinate it. And
yeah.
I don't know, so sometimes it takes a couple, 3 years to get these projects done. But
sometimes it takes 15 or 20 years to get it started. Doing it, it happens. You just stick with it, and you get it done. Back to Bog 12. We wouldn't have any trouble reinvesting trees there. North Atlantic Cedars, there'd be no speed bumps in the way, putting them in once we get them.
Where now?
Bog 12, behind the water pond. We already put the North Atlantic Cedars on for the 350th.
That you would have to bring up to
that's
the DPW.
That's the DPW.
Okay, so could you kind of spearhead that part of
it? This is kind of one of those, theirs, ours. In other words, they are the custodian of the property, so you have to have their permission. You have to have this board's permission because you're planting trees into a wetland area or a resource area. So yeah, you have to have both people, but you have to have theirs really first because they have the power of saying, I don't want you planting trees.
So one of us should go to the DPW meeting.
We could piggyback off the 300 still, or is this a new project? Because we still have the whole project,
I don't think we have any project that's...
Well, the 300 was reforestation. It was long-term management. It says it all in the proposals. And it was granted, and we did it. We didn't plant where they didn't want us to. We planted where they say we could. It was very successful. And is that still an open-end project?
My honest opinion, I think it would just be a friendly heads up.
Oh yeah, no, I'm looking at that's what I'm saying.
Just inform the commissioners what
and again, I would say that you should at least file paperwork here.
Ask for permission, absolutely. Well,
again, because we're the governing and we don't want to have anyone say that we're sidestepping.
It's not immune to my own rules.
I say it's so simple to handle it here.
Before.
And there's no money involved in handling it here other than advertising. We do have enough advertising budget.
I would make it so that at this meeting we can approve the fact that we go forward and we, next week, do we have to advertise this? Next week we can bring this to fellation at this board at least, and then I can bring that proposal to them, or is it in reverse?
We should do. You should get there first. Okay.
Bring him first.
And say, that's what I'm checking. Hey, I know what this.
What we want to do is we want to know.
Okay.
But what I might suggest, Rick, if watering the trees is a time sensitive.
Right now, it's very sensitive.
If you water the trees of 3 or 5, whatever, if we order those trees, if for some reason we can't plant them on the DPW property, we have bogs of our own that we could give you permission to put them in, so it wouldn't be wasting of the trees. It may not go where we want them, but I have no doubt
that to me, if I believe in it, it's very important that we continue to cover Bog 12, it being a water resource and drainage into a water reservoir. The more trees you put there, the more sphagnum moss we build there, the better the future is as a water resource.
Well, see, we could say the same thing about windswept bogs off of Gorham Ave, because that bog's going into a water resource area also.
Yeah, it sure is. It sure is.
Okay, so we're done with that.
But nobody has started the project there like I have, so I think this would be easier to facilitate right there for...
So I have to ask the person who really doesn't know, because everybody constantly asks me, Bog 12. Is that the bog behind the barn?
Yeah, the sinking bog.
Okay, I had to ask because I've asked several people and go, what the hell are you talking about, Bog 12?
Last thing in defense of planting there, that is the only 97-foot deep peat bed that I know of, and that should have a beautiful ground cover of North Atlantic Cedars. The Army Corps of Engineers agrees that was there and that they would be indigenous to that area. Last one?
I never knew it was Bog 12. I've worked for that.
Yeah.
I found out by coincidence. I thought it was the peat bog.
That was known as Lower Bog.
Yeah.
That's all.
There you go. It's the last bog, Lower Bog.
All right.
So I think what we have left is to vote on the meeting minutes of February 6th, 2017. Everybody had time to review them?
Yes, I have, and I will make a motion to accept the meeting.
I will sign it.
Of the meeting of February 6th, 2017.
Motion has been made and seconded to approve the minutes of February 6th, 2017. All in favor?
Aye.
While we're talking minutes, we have received some communication from powers to be that we're still shy one set of minutes. Was what you were going to have?
That's the ones that I have.
And they were down this week wanting to know where the one went and said they were on the way.
Okay, I'll get that off. I had someone put the minutes together, but I got the wrong meeting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's the one. What was the date on that again? Sorry, can I do that? Do you have it?
Nope.
Okay.
We can find out what the actual date was.
Is that something that Rachel could do? I have it recorded by audio. And we just need it transcribed. Is that something that
I think we voted to have whoever did yours last time do it again, we'll pay them again. If they will. If they won't, then we can find someone else.
We need to find someone else.
All right. All right, then maybe Rachel will talk. We'll find someone who can transcribe it.
Okay. Whatever you guys decide.
Yeah.
Well, is that something that you would do?
I don't know. I think it's up to you guys.
She
said that.
Can we? Because I'm sure she's running ragged right now, trying to catch up. Can we vote to give Rachel extra hours? Yep. To catch up on this?
Yeah, we've already voted that we pay someone to do it, so...
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Rachel
wants
to do it.
It's up to you, Rachel.
If you get it to Rachel...
Absolutely, as long as it's what you guys want to... Yeah. I'll do whatever you guys want me to do.
I just figure, just getting into it, I'm sure there's... Even though that office is small, it was packed pretty tight. So I'm sure your time is stretched very thin right now. So if you think you would have time on after your regular stuff... And we can pay you to take care of transcribing Art's minutes.
Yeah.
I would be more than happy to vote that if we need to, or whatever we need to do.
I think what I'd like to say, if Art can get her the thing, then we'll let her decide whether she wants to do it or whether she wants to farm it out for someone else to do it.
Right.
You know, and whatever way that it's, and we'll put it in the middle after.
So either I'll do it or I'll.
She's the one that's going to hear from up above that.
Whatever works for you.
Okay.
It'll be a good education for you, too, to hear that meeting.
Okay.
All right.
So that's it.
As long as... Has everyone signed that certificate of compliance? This was from... It is?
Okay, great. Compliance, we voted it last week, but we didn't have the...
The signature page. Great. Thank you.
Yeah, let's plan it again.
There's four signatures on here?
Beautiful.
Wait,
did
you sign that?
Yes, it did.
Well, that's you, yeah.
Who didn't sign? Bob, did you sign?
Looks like Bob didn't sign.
Okay.
I signed trees and fish.
Do we need to talk about this at all?
Spelling errors.
For this letter to...
Oh, yeah, we can.
That's right, I already gave her that. That was on the in the mail.
Yeah.
The National Grid maintenance thing there.
Well, no, this is the...
This is the order of conditions that were disputed, and looks like DEP has reached a resolution or formed an opinion on that.
Yeah, for, I just read it a little while ago. It seems they've approved the placement of the water wheel with some extra conditions. So
a superseding order.
And it looks like they approved our amended order of conditions, is what that was for.
Yeah.
Because the amended one was appealed. So it appears as though that has gone through.
It's still in its appeal period. In other words, they have done it now. It has so many days of appeal before it becomes...
Correct.
Correct.
So is anybody appealing it? Have you heard anything?
And we have not seen any paperwork on it, but
I don't know if
that was only a week ago it came, so it's right. ten, I think it's 10 business days or something
would
like that.
Would it come to us or would it go, or would it go to DEP?
Sure.
You know, and usually appeals come at the last minute.
Understood.
Speaking about appeals, I think this board was here on Valley Street when we denied the two lots. There is now a new
proposal.
A new proposal.
Are they married?
A new proposal. It's on the agenda for next week, and perhaps we shouldn't even discuss it because
right.
of the open meeting. But there's one on, and now that makes it look like maybe we should have accepted what we had, because what we have was better than what's they're proposing.
Coming?
Yeah.
Well, it wasn't approved by planning board. That was the only reason why we put that off, right?
What?
The planning board hadn't done anything with it.
Right.
And number one, they weren't combined yet. It was just
were planning
high in the sky.
But you know, the lots are approved because they're old lots.
Yeah.
Right.
But now they've added more to it and done a lot of other crazy things.
Road in there.
If anyone would like to look at the plan, we have a plan in the office and it's on schedule for next week, but
next week. Pretty simple.
It's not necessarily pretty.
No, never is in those things.
Motion to adjourn.
One more thing. I just wanted to let anyone who doesn't already know that Sharon has given her resignation from the commission. So now we have two open seats.
Oh, Sharon Toole?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. Just today.
I did not know that.
Just today, that's why it wasn't in the agenda. I'm sorry?
Is it something we did?
It's everything we didn't do.
Oh, well. Okay. Well, we'll have to send her a thank you letter or something.
Absolutely.
Like that.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
invite her back if she has a change of heart.
I think we want to ask Rachel to get a hold of, I think, first Sabrina and then Deb Wall and get postings there are openings.
Well, I've heard that soon I'll be trained on how to do all of that myself.
Okay.
Which is great. Well, it really is.
Have
I mean, to not
the board
have to
members
ask
you asked me to do
someone to do it for me.
The board members that
yeah, there's still old board members on our
yes,
website.
There's still so. Several old board of the previous board members that are listed.
Really? Because like I sent a new. Almost. See, this is why it's going to be great to be trained on it because I can just go in and change it myself. But I did send a new list to Deb, so
she hasn't put it on yet.
Yeah, I don't think she's gotten to
all
it
right.
yet. So.
Okay.
If we could just check
I'll
that.
Put a little bug in her ear.
Yeah, put it, but,
thank you.
But I think we want to get out to
correct.
The public that,
that
there are now
members.
Some openings, you know, and that you know we would. I think we need to give them as you know we need a couple weeks of chance for people to think about it and apply, and then we can look them over.
Also, we have an applicant here. If you would, I would say we give him the floor if he'd like it for a minute to give us his. Ideas or what he wants to do on the board. He's already got an application in, and he's here.
Yes, I'd like to, but we
get to meet him.
Yeah, I was going to say, do we have to wait? Do
that's
we have?
I
mean,
right.
If we're looking at him and,
okay.
and not look like we were.
Right, has to be on the agenda in the middle of the meetings attended according to the town.
Would you like to make an appointment to speak?
If he wants to speak to us, he can speak to us. At any time about what things like
right.
that.
Right.
I can come before early before next meeting. Is it next Monday? I can come out.
Yeah, well, we can put it on there for next Monday. That's fine.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're going to come, because technically, according to town bylaw, you need to attend two meetings anyways before you'd be eligible for consideration.
Let's go
three
that.
Meetings.
No, let's go
absolutely. Three meetings, I believe, to be privy.
Is that three?
I thought it was
no,
two.
I thought it was just two.
Two.
Yeah.
Okay.
Two. Yeah.
Yeah.
Big
sure.
Okay. In your case, it was three because you.
Yeah,
it's
a little small.
It takes a little longer. Yeah.
Yeah. And drag it out.
Awesome. Perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Awesome.
And put it out just like they recruited us when we all signed up for Boy Scouts. It's only 1 hour a week.
Yeah.
1 hour a week.
I think somebody got me drunk. I'm even report like
all right.
The chair.
Now are you ready for that motion?